Hello and welcome to this TestNG video playlist. I am your instructor, Rex Jones II. You can follow me on YouTube, LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, and GitHub. All of the source code will be on GitHub. You can go to my website at rexjones2.com if you want to see my books, blogs, and other videos. In this tutorial, we will walk through step-by-step through some TestNG features. The features start with annotations. After annotations, we will create our first test using Selenium and TestNG. Then assertions, followed by parameterizations. We are going to parameterize our test using the parameters annotations. Next is taking a screenshot of an application, but only take the screenshot if the test failed. When it comes to dynamic weight statements, they are Selenium features that I will combine with TestNG. The next tutorial is super important, and that is the page object model. It is not a framework, but it is a design pattern that is part of a framework. The benefits of a page object model include code maintenance, code maintainability, and code reusability. The last three tutorials consist of parallel testing. In that same tutorial, I will also demo data providers, then cross-browser testing using TestNG and Cloud Selenium Grid. We will close with geolocation. Before we get started with the features, let me first introduce TestNG. What is TestNG? TestNG is a test framework for writing test scripts and running test scripts. The purpose is to inspect the testing process of an application. Test frameworks are important because it simplifies the process of testing. They simplify the process by making it easy to run a quick test. Another way test frameworks simplify the process is by providing the ability to run our test as a collection. The four core functions of most test frameworks include creating and executing test scripts, generating test reports, generating test logs, last but not least, reading and writing test data. The complete name for TestNG is Test Next Generation. It is the next generation for testing, and it includes many features for testing, such as parallel testing, integration testing, dependency testing, data-driven testing, cross-browser testing, end-to-end testing, and other types of testing. We can set up TestNG more than one way. However, I would use IntelliJ to set up our test, and we would see Maven as the default when clicking new project. We can also click Gradle to set up TestNG. Now we click Next. Provide a name like tutorials TestNG. And finish. Inside of the pom.xml file, we should see the properties tag. The property tag compiles our code. Now, after clicking the properties tag, we must add the dependencies tag by clicking the left angle bracket, then selecting dependencies. The shortcut way to type a dependency and add dependency is to click the angle bracket again, then select dependency. For the shortcut, we will add the dependency name inside the group ID or the artifact ID. Let's use the group ID. Inside of it, hit control space, then add the dependency that we want, and that is TestNG. Select org.testng, then select the version 7.4.0. Now we have the TestNG dependency. Let's also add two more dependencies. And those dependencies are Selenium for automation and WebDriver Manager to automatically manage our drivers. When using Maven, we can also go to MVN repository. This site has many dependencies. Search for Selenium 4. And after we see Selenium 4, after searching, there are many options. At this point, sometimes people get confused because there are many Selenium options. I will select Selenium Java because it also includes other dependencies such as Selenium Support, Selenium Chrome Driver, and other drivers. So Selenium Java takes us to the version part. We see 4.2.2 is the latest version, but I'm going to select the official first Selenium 4 version, then copy the dependency. Go back to the IDE, then paste the dependency. Now we have Selenium Java. For WebDriver Manager, let's use a shortcut by clicking the angle bracket, dependency, inside artifact ID, I'm going to hit control space, then type WebDriver Manager. And for the group ID, I'm going to select io.github.bonygarcia. For the version, 5.0.3. If you have any issues with your Maven project for its loading and you see any red lines, you can load your Maven changes. Control-Shift-O is the shortcut. Now we are finished setting up our TestNG dependency. We're finished setting up Selenium and WebDriver Manager. Next is the TestNG annotations. If you would like to learn more, then make sure to follow the blogs at www.lambdatest.com/blog and community.lambdatest.com. In addition to the blogs, you can earn a certification at www.lambdatest.com/certifications. Get educated, get recognized.